Hello.
Yeah, is this Dr. Freud?
Who is this, please?
This is Colonel Harland Sanders. We've never met.
How did you get this number?
I don't remember rightly, but anyway, I got you on the horn, so I want to take advantage of this opportunity to ask you a pertinent remark or two.
What can I do for you?
Well, as I understand it, you're one of the main head shrinkers out there, and renowned and all that. Anyway, I've been having some strange dreams lately, and I thought I'd run them past you and see if there's anything to be concerned about. Since you're the expert, I figured you might be forthcoming.
The dreams you've been having. You must pardon me, Colonel?
Yeah, that's right, Colonel. Colonel Harland Sanders.
Yeah. You must forgive me, it's quite late at night in Vienna.
Vienna?
Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Indiana right now, in the United States of America.
All right, tell me your dream.
Well, I get this dream where I'm in a parade, which is not all that unusual, in real life, I mean.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, I'm in a parade, but when I look around, I see that there's no people in the stands or on the side of the road or anything like that. It's just a lot of chickens, but they're plucked chickens.
Yeah.
And then each of them's got a little, I don't know, I guess like a penny whistle in their beak.
Penny whistle?
Yeah, it's a cheap little round whistle. Anyway, they're blowing these whistles out of their beak, and then all of a sudden I find that I'm on a waterfall.
Continue, please.
Well, and then I go over the waterfall, and then suddenly I'm in a big boat, and there's a chicken running that boat as a captain.
Yeah.
I hope I'm not boring you.
No. I'm just taking notes.
Oh, well, that's good. Anyway, it all winds up with me on the boat, which is a very well-appointed little boat, by the way. It's, you could call it a yacht. But it's all going into a big whirlpool in the middle of the ocean. And a chicken captain is squawking, and some of the other passengers, which are also plucked chickens, are squawking. And we all go down this hole, and then it's all black, and well, that's about when I wake up.
Uh-huh. And this is your recurring nightmare, would you say?
Yeah, well, it's not pleasant.
Yeah. Okay.
So, what do you think? Is there any hope?
Colonel, let me ask you something. First of all, dreams are really not very significant.
No?
No. I have found in analysis that it is going down a blind alley, frankly. And, excuse me.
Oh, no problem.
Let me ask you one question.
Oh, sure. I appreciate it very much.
Are you in the habit of eating a large meal for dinner before you retire?
Oh, yeah, you betcha. Uh-huh. I've been in the habit of that for a long time.
And what do you usually eat?
Well, chicken, of course, most of the time. Every now and then I'll have a piece of fish, but more often than not, I'll be eating some of my own hand-breaded and hand-washed chicken.
Yeah, well, I think this might be a possible contributing factor to having these nightmares. Why don't you don't eat so much chicken before you go to bed, Colonel?
Not eat chicken before I go to bed, huh? I mean, I'm just writing this down here. Don't eat chicken before you go to bed. Well, you think that'll handle it, or do I have a more underlying mental illness? Tell me straight. I can take it.
No, Colonel, I don't think so. Of course, it is impossible for me to make a diagnosis over the phone, and particularly on such a long-distance call when I'm barely awake. And, of course, I've discontinued my practice for some time, to be honest.
Oh, you have? Oh, I didn't realize you were retired.
Well, I passed away in 1939.
Really? Oh, how about that? It was 1980 for me.
That could be another cause of having nightmares. Well, I hope that I've been of some help to you.
Oh, yeah, it's been a big relief, Dr. Freud. I appreciate it very much. Can I send you a check or anything like that?
No, it's not necessary, but if you would, please never call this number again.
Uh-huh. Oh, even in an emergency?
Especially in an emergency, Colonel.
Oh, fair enough.